Text on screen. Be advised, sensitive language. Close up of Reggie Ballard.
When we were traveling north to go to this golf course, and the guy said, they used to call that Nigger Mountain. It didn't bother me in that I didn't know that that was my great-grandfather they were talking about.
Mountains framed by branches. A hillside comes into focus with a cross sitting at the top against a blue sky. A hazy mountain ridge. A fourth scene of a sunny Ballard Mountain. A close-up of Ryan Ballard sitting in a chair speaking to camera.
My name is Ryan Ballard. I am the son of Reginald Ballard, the son of Claudius Ballard, who is the son of William Ballard, who is the son of John Ballard.
Text on screen. To right or wrong the story of Ballard Mountain. An animation of the Earth is shown and zooms into a satellite view of the Santa Monica Mountains. A red marker shows the location of Ballard Mountain.
In the Santa Monica Mountains, just outside the western edges of the city of Los Angeles, there's a 2,031-foot peak that rises above the rock-cropped hills of Malibu. From the top, you could glimpse the Pacific Ocean and inhale the cool sea breezes. Early government topographic maps of the Santa Monica Mountains list this peak's name as a racial slur.
Topographic map.
When a handful of individuals spoke up, their actions reverberated across the region.
Various close-ups of individuals being interviewed. Leah and Paul Colbert sit side by side. Patty Coleman, David Zemanski, Reggie Ballard, and Ryan Ballard.
It touched many. And ultimately, these actions would end up touching the Ballards, the descendants of the family whom the mountain was named for. Leah and Paul Kulberg have lived in a shadow of Ballard Mountain for 45 years. Early on, a neighbor gave them a lay of the land.
Ryan and Paul knew Ballard Mountain.
Bob one day was up here and telling us about the area and that Saddle Rock is right over there. It's a locally known landmark, and Mitten Rock you can see from here. And then you come around and he said, and you wouldn't believe what that mountain is called.
And he told us, and we went and started doing a little bit of research.
Nick Noxon, who has since passed away, was a National Geographic TV producer, and he first learned of Black homesteader John Ballard when he found a copy of a book in the Agoura Public Library describing the charismatic former slave.
Historic photo of John Ballard.
Both he and his wife, Nikki, along with the Kulbergs, felt compelled to act. They lobbied county officials to initiate a formal name change of the mountain peak in 2009.
Sunset on Ballard Mountain.
You know, it just seemed like the right thing to do. I mean, it was a good idea. We hated the idea of what it was known as. And we thought that we needed to recognize this man.
Patty Coleman interviewed.
It was around this time that the families met Moore Park College history professor Patty Coleman. They heard her speak about the Ballard family at a National Park Service event. She had done extensive research on the history of the Santa Monica Mountains and the people who lived here long ago. Soon after, the Los Angeles Times ran a story about the proposed name change for the mountain.
Newspaper story.
For over a century, John Ballard's land and his mountain were known pejoratively, but that was about to change. The front page story caught the eye of one Los Angeles family in particular. Reggie Ballard Sr. remembered gazing at the grainy photo that accompanied the story. The older bearded gentleman with the broad, rugged shoulders and large hulking frame in the picture looked familiar somehow.
It was really destiny. I know that sounds so dramatic, but you know, here I am at work getting the LA Times. You know, we read the paper, you know, before the start of work, and obviously I'm drawn to this cover story that has a guy who has my same last name. Mm-hmm. So I called my dad and he said, Ryan, I'm looking at this fella. I immediately knew what he was talking about, who reminds me of somebody in my family.
Close up of Reggie Ballard.
Before long, their family, other descendants of John Ballard, were drawn into this piece of local history.
Ryan Ballard.
really this is a kind of a history of a lot of African Americans. That is, we don't always know from whence we came or why we operate the way we do.
In the coming months, the Culbergs, the Knoxons, Patty Coleman, and the descendants of John Ballard met. They formed strong bonds, and to this day, they see each other as family. In 2010, N-wordhead Mountain was renamed. Reggie Ballard, the great-grandson of John Ballard, Ryan's father, was presented with the first printed map bearing the mountain's new name, Ballard Mountain.
Leah Goldberg.
It's just about people getting together and doing what's right. And sometimes it's a whole lot easier than anybody imagines it can be. And so people shouldn't be afraid to try.
Much of the land the mountain sits on is part of the Santa Monica Mountains National Recreation Area, managed by the National Park Service and the state of California.
Sunset on Ballard Mountain, David Zamansky.
This park was established to serve all of the residents of Southern California and the Los Angeles area, and specifically, regardless of gender, race, ethnic background.
Diverse groups recreating.
We've always thought here if we're, if our visitors don't look like the city and the county and the region, that we haven't fully met our objectives. And the Ballard Mountain story is important because it shows that people of color have been a part, an integral part of this area for quite some time. And beyond that, I think it shows a century and a half of perseverance against almost overwhelming odds, against prejudice, violence in the form of fires and other efforts to get John Ballard and his daughter Alice to leave the mountains. And the fact that the family not only was able to survive this, but to thrive and to continue to contribute to both the country and to the local area in successive generations has been really inspiring.
Ryan Ballard.
You know, so often people will give attention to something because it's media worthy, you know, but this was something that a group of folks thought was worthwhile, and there was no thought about any celebrity that might come along with it. So I definitely think it is important, and I hope that, you know, for those who are just now giving ear and or attention to monuments and names and understanding how important they are and the impact they can have, I hope this is yet one other account that resonates in the hearts and the minds of people to reinforce what is happening in the larger society.
Satellite map view.
John Ballard and his family have all contributed to making this massive, sprawling city a better place to live.
Ryan Ballard.
I've always known my family, a native of Los Angeles, and I've always known my father was a native of Los Angeles. My father was born in 1924. It was never a big deal to me, but apparently to other people it was a big deal. So when I would say I was from Los Angeles, people would always remark, oh yeah, not a lot of people are, you know, from Los Angeles. I would say, well, my dad's from Los Angeles too, and he was born in 1924, and they would be shocked. I'd say, yeah, my grandfather and his father, you know, so I knew that much about my family, that we had a fairly long history dating back more than 100 years in the city of Los Angeles.
Historic photos of Los Angeles change on screen.
John Ballard left Kentucky and arrived in Los Angeles in 1859. Back when this was a sleepy, yet growing city. He had become active in civic affairs and was one of the founding members of the city's first African Methodist Episcopal Church. In 1880, Ballard picked up his family and moved about 50 miles west to the Santa Monica Mountains. He purchased 160 acres of land. The family raised some livestock and a few crops. Ballard collected firewood and sold it in the city.
Historic storefront.
He was described as an intelligent and literate man. He distinguished himself as an extraordinary individual who worked hard and persevered despite attempts by others to drive him off his land.
Workers and horses in a field.
Despite his accomplishments, Ballard was mistreated by other pioneers due to the color of his skin. Thieves unsuccessfully tried to chase Ballard from his home. His cabin was set on fire twice, but he was not easily deterred. He rebuilt his home both times.
Image of Ballard family home, Hattie Coleman.
From our very founding in this country, going back to the colonial times in the 17th century, laws and customs were in place to create a racial hierarchy and to strip Black people of their humanity. And that's why I think the story of John Ballard and what he accomplished is so incredible, because while forces were trying to strip him of his humanity, he found ways to succeed against all odds.
Alice Ballard in front of home.
Years later, one of his seven children, Alice Ballard, became a homesteader herself. An unusual feat for any woman, much more a woman of color.
Map of Ballard Lane.
She claimed an adjoining lot, and another 160 acres was added to the Ballard family land. She eventually married and moved to Los Angeles. Her father, John Ballard, died in 1905 when he was about 75 years old.
Photo of John Ballard.
The Ballard family continued to distinguish themselves over the decades.
Ballard family photos.
Claudius, John Ballard's grandson, was a Berkeley-educated doctor who fought during World War I. He was awarded the Croix de Guerre by the French for his bravery. Both of his sons fought in World War II, Albert Lucky Ballard and Reggie Ballard, who was a Tuskegee airman.
Group photo of Tuskegee airman.
Reggie helped desegregate the Los Angeles City Fire Department decades ago. He and his wife, Margaret, had six children. Reggie passed away on June 30th, 2021. He was just shy of his 97th birthday.
Reggie Ballard in uniform.
Reggie's youngest child, Ryan, works as a special education teacher in Los Angeles.
Ryan Ballard sitting in chair.
After the name change, I still had to go to work. I still have to care for my family. And, you know, but again, I get to tell my children that, okay, this there's something that bears your name. And with that comes responsibility. And so make sure you live up to it.
Photo of John Ballard.
We're just a regular family, not, you know, anything special. But we're a part of fabric of the society, so we're no less than and we're no more than, and people I think can relate to that. This is not, you know, this story does not exist in a vacuum. There's many others that this is a part of the American story.
Text on screen, produced by the National Park Service. Logo appears on screen, funded by Santa Monica Mountains Fund and the National Park Service. Both logos appear on screen. Directed by Darius Dawson. Written and narrated by Anna Beatrice Cholo. Cinematography by Darius Dawson. Edited by Austin Roy. Additional photography by Kayla McCrary. Featuring Reginald Ballard, Ryan Ballard, Paul Colbert, Leah Colbert, Patty Coleman, David Szymanski. Special thanks to Rosalind Ballard Dollar, Reginald Ballard II, Roderick Ballard, Rhonda Sullins, Regina Ballard, National Park Service Southern California Research Learning Center, The Los Angeles Times. Photographs provided by Beverly Hills Public Library Historical Collection, Minnie Mason Charitable Foundation, California Historical Society Collection, USC Libraries, Cincinnati Art Museum, Los Angeles Public Library, National Park Service, USC Libraries, Water and Power Associates. Animated maps provided by Google Earth, footage of Nick Knoxon provided by Television Academy Foundation, National Geographic. In loving memory of Reginald Ballard Sr., November 21, 1924 to June 30, 2021. Image of Reginald Ballard in uniform.